Hi students, welcome to Advanced English Class, second semester. Today's lesson, chapter 3, Extending and Accepting Invitations. In this lesson, you are going to learn two things. One is how to invite, how to extend your invitation. Your friends, relatives, colleagues, neighbors, on the occasion of marriage, birthday parties, celebrations, gatherings, marriage, something, and different occasions. And the second one is accepting invitations. How do you accept invitation when your friends, your colleagues, your neighbors, your relatives, your well-wishers extend invitation? Here, in accepting invitation, you have one more thing is inability in accepting invitation. How do you reject? How do you say your inability in attending the function or party? Okay. So, invitations are usually given to relatives, friends, neighbors, colleagues for special occasions such as birthdays, marriages, celebrations, gatherings. Formal invitations are given to officials, colleagues, and persons in higher positions. In accepting a formal invitation, it is important to respond appropriately. First, thank the person for the invitation and then express your acceptance. If you are unable to accept the invitation, you have to say thank you for inviting, and after that you can give proper reason why you are unable to attend. Not only this, when somebody invite you for the occasion, celebration, you have to say thanks for inviting. That is minimum courtesy. Okay. Suppose here is one pre-activity. How will you invite your teacher to a farewell party? You are going to give farewell party to third year students. You know, they are going at end of the academic year. They are going to leave the college. You want to leave a farewell party to them. Along with the students, you are going to invite the teachers for the farewell party. How will you invite them? What kind of expressions, sentences you use while inviting? Your friend has invited you to his sister's wedding. How do you accept the invitation? You have been invited to a housewarming ceremony, but you have some important work on that day. How will you express your inability to attend the function in a polite manner? So all these questions are related to invitations, extending invitation, accepting invitation, expressing inability to invitations. So maybe you can say, suppose first one, how will you invite your teacher to a farewell party? Suppose we are going to give farewell party to our seniors. I request you, sir, madam, please attend the party tomorrow 11 a.m. at Lakshmi Gardens function hall. In that manner, you say, is it correct or not? You are going to know after completing this lesson. Next, your friend has invited you to his sister's wedding. How do you accept the invitation? Generally, you say, congratulations. I will definitely attend the marriage function. Is it correct manner or not? You are going to learn in soon. Next, you have been invited to a housewarming ceremony. but you have some important work on that day. How will you express your inability to attend the function in a polite manner? Suppose, thank you for inviting me for your housewarming ceremony, but I'm sorry, I am unable to attend the function because on the same day I have an important exam. I have to write exam. I have to attend an exam. Okay, here is one activity. Activity 1. Read the following conversation between two friends and identify the phrases used to extend and accept invitation. Mahi and Gauri. First, Mahi. Hi Gauri, how are you? Gauri. Hi, after a long time, how are you? Anything special? Mahi. Yes, my brother's marriage has been fixed. Gauri. Convey my congratulations to him. When is the marriage? Mahi. The marriage is on the 10th of next month. Here is the invitation. Gauri. Oh, the marriage is on Sunday. Mahi. Please do attend the marriage. If you let me know your travel details, I will make necessary arrangements. Gauri. Thanks for the invitation. I will definitely attend the marriage. See here, my brother's marriage has been fixed. Here is the invitation. Please do attend the marriage. Okay, thank you for the invitation. I will definitely attend the marriage. So here, invitation and accepting polite manner are there. Okay, right. Next. Activity 2. Work with your partner. That means in classroom. Invite your friend to do the following with you. Reverse roles and use different expressions. An example has been done for you. Okay. Here, you have to invite in the following situations your friend. 1. Come and jog with you in the mornings. You have to invite your friend, come and jog with you in the mornings. How do you invite? Why don't you come and jog with me in the mornings? Like that. Next, go for yoga in the evening. How do you invite? Yes. Why don't you come for yoga in the evening? Right. You can say like that. Why don't you come and practice yoga with me in the evenings also? Next, play tennis with you. Why don't you come and play tennis with me? Here, you should not say go because you are inviting. You are inviting him to play with you. To play with you. So, you have to change that word. Okay. Why don't you come and play tennis with me? Next, go on a tour. Why don't you come and join me on a tour. Next, join computer classes. Why don't you join the computer classes? Attend a seminar on road safety. Why don't you attend a seminar on road safety? Like that. Modal expressions. Next, here is the detailed explanation, detailed information about how to invite, how to accept, how to express inability. Okay. In accepting a formal invitation, it is important to respond appropriately. Appropriately means suitably. First, thank the person for the invitation and then express your acceptance. Okay, expressions used for accepting invitations. There are different ways of accepting invitation because this is a English. You can use different expressions. Yes, thank you. Of course, I would like to. Thank you, that would be great. Thank you, that sounds great. On some occasions, you may not be able to attend, and therefore, you will have to politely express your inability to attend giving the reason. Expressions used for expressing inability to attend. See, thank you, but I am sorry, I may not. Suppose marriage function. Thank you for inviting me, but I am sorry, I may not attend the marriage. On the same day, I have an appointment with the doctor. So give some reason, whatever it may be. Thank you, but I am afraid, I cannot give the reason. Thank you, but I won't be able to attend. Give the reason. Like that. You have to by heart all these expressions. In examination point of view, you get 1 mark questions, 3 marks questions, and 5 marks questions from this lesson. It is very important. They ask you to write a conversation regarding extending invitation, accepting invitation, and also give some modal expressions. How do you invite? How do you accept? How do you express your inability? You have to give some modal expressions in 1 mark questions. Next, activity 3. Work in groups of 3. This means, okay, leave it. Make as many meaningful sentences as possible using the expressions given in the table. What you have to do is here. That means there are three points are there here. Invitation, first point is invitation, second point is accepting, third point is expressing inability. You have to write invite invitation sentence, expression, and you have to write accepting invitation sentence, and third one is expressing inability sentence. Okay, suppose one model. We can express invitations in 2 ways. One is, would you like to, and second one is, why don't you? Here. Would you like to come to party on Sunday? Saturday. Would you like to come to a party on Saturday? Acceptance. Yes. Thank you. Of course, I will come to the party on that day. Suppose inability. Thanks, but I am sorry. I may not attend the party on Saturday because I will be out of station. Or why don't you come to party on Saturday? Yes, thank you. I would like to. You can change. You can. There are different ways of expressing thanks. Yes, thank you. Of course, I would like to. That would be great. That sounds great. That sounds great. That would be great. I would like to. Of course, I would like to. Yes, thank you. Inability. Thanks. I am sorry. Thanks. I may not. Thank you. I am afraid I cannot. Thank you, but I am unable to. So, would you like to come out with me this evening? Yes, of course. Sorry, I can't. Why don't you come with me for a lunch? That would be great. I would like to, but I am unable to as I am busy. Would you like to come and see me? That sounds great. I'm afraid I cannot. Why don't you listen to my new record? Of course, I will. I want to, but I am unable to listen. Would you like to come and meet my family? That would be great. I am afraid I cannot. Like that. Next, activity 4. Work with your partner. So, leave it. Write a complete dialogue and role play them. Each one of you can take one situation to invite. Okay, right. Your friend invites you to attend his birthday marriage. Brother's marriage. Your friend invites you to attend his brother's marriage. So, write invitation, write acceptance, and also inability. I will give you one modal expression. You can write in any way. There are different ways are there. Okay. Suppose Deepak and Vinay. Deepak. Congrats, Raj. I would definitely attend your brother's marriage. Suppose. Congrats, Raj. I'm afraid I cannot attend your brother's wedding as I have to travel out of the town on an emergency. Okay. Next. Your neighbor invites you to join him at a cultural program in your locality on a festival day. How do you accept? How do you express your inability? Acceptance. That would be great. I will join you for cultural program on festival day. Suppose if you want to say inability, that would be great. But I'm sorry, I'm unable to participate in the cultural program as I have an exam on that day. In that, there are different reasons you can see. Okay, some common errors generally we make in invitations. Example, I invite you, Lakshmi, why don't you come to the party? Here, I invite you and Lakshmi, both are there. So it is not good. So delete it. I invite you and use Lakshmi. Okay. Lakshmi, why don't you come to the party, please? Next. Invite him for the function. No. Invite him to the function, not for the function. Okay. Tips. Extend invitations with a smile. Practice using various polite expressions in your speech. Thank the person for invitation. Confirm your participation. If you are not able to confirm, it is polite to inform the reason for your inability to accept. Okay, next assignments you have to do. Extend an invitation to a local celebrity to be the guest of honor for the annual day function in your college. Okay. Next, suppose one modal expression. We the students of final year civil engineering have planned for the annual day function in our college on 15th of this month. We wholeheartedly invite you to the guest of honor, to be the guest of honor and make this event colorful and lively in that way. Next, invite your seniors to attend a farewell party. We, the students of second year electrical engineering, are conducting a farewell party this Saturday for all the seniors. We would like you all to attend it and make it a memorable event. So you can write in a different manner, okay? That is a different thing. So this is the lesson. Please go through it once again, repeat it once again. I will share the PDF along with this video in YouTube. Complete the assignments and activities. Write them in your notebook, Fair Notes. If you have any doubts, if you want any clarification, you can ask me in the live class, regular class. Until then, I am closing this session. Thank you very much. Hi students, welcome to Advanced English class, second semester. Today's lesson, chapter 3, Extending and Accepting Invitations. In this lesson, you are going to learn two things. One is how to invite, how to extend your invitation. Your friends, relatives, colleagues, neighbors, on the occasion of marriage, birthday parties, celebrations, gatherings, marriage, something, and different occasions. And the second one is accepting invitations. How do you accept invitation when your friends, your colleagues, your neighbors, your relatives, your well-wishers extend invitation? Here, in accepting invitation, you have one more thing, is inability in accepting invitation. How do you reject? How do you say your inability in attending the function or party? Okay. So invitations are usually given to relatives, friends, neighbors, colleagues for special occasions such as birthdays, marriages, celebrations, gatherings. Formal invitations are given to officials, colleagues, and persons in higher positions. In accepting a formal invitation, it is important to respond appropriately. First, thank the person for the invitation and then express your acceptance. If you are unable to accept the invitation, you have to say thank you for inviting, and after that you can give proper reason why you are unable to attend. Not only this, when somebody invite you for the occasion, celebration, you have to say thanks for inviting. That is minimum courtesy. Okay, suppose here is one pre-activity. How will you invite your teacher to a farewell party? You are going to give farewell party to third year students. You know, they are going at end of the academic year, they are going to leave the college. You want to leave a farewell party to them. Along with the students, you are going to invite the teachers for the farewell party. How will you invite them? What kind of expressions, sentences you use while inviting? Your friend has invited you to his sister's wedding. How do you accept the invitation? You have been invited to a housewarming ceremony, but you have some important work on that day. How will you express your inability to attend the function in a polite manner? So all these questions are related to invitations, extending invitation, accepting invitation, expressing inability to invitations. So maybe you can say, suppose first one, how will you invite your teacher to a farewell party? Suppose we are going to give farewell party to our seniors. I request you, sir, madam, please attend the party tomorrow 11 a.m. at Lakshmi Gardens Function Hall. In that manner, you say, is it correct or not? You are going to know after completing this lesson. Next, your friend has invited you to his sister's wedding. How do you accept the invitation? Generally, you say, congratulations, I will definitely attend the marriage function. Is it correct manner or not? You are going to learn in soon. Next, you have been invited to a housewarming ceremony, but you have some important work on that day. How will you express your inability to attend the function in a polite manner? Suppose, thank you for inviting me for your housewarming ceremony, but I'm sorry, I am unable to attend the function because on the same day I have an important exam. I have to write exam. I have to attend an exam. Okay, here is one activity. Activity 1. Read the following conversation between two friends and identify the phrases used to extend and accept invitation. Mahi and Gauri. First, Mahi. Hi, Gauri. How are you? Gauri. Hi. After a long time, how are you? Anything special? Mahi. Yes. My brother's marriage has been fixed. Gauri. Convey my congratulations to him. When is the marriage? Mahi. The marriage is on the 10th of next month. Here is the invitation. Gauri. Oh, the marriage is on Sunday. Mahi. Please do attend the marriage. If you let me know your travel details, I will make necessary arrangements. Gauri. Thanks for the invitation. I will definitely attend the marriage. See here, my brother's marriage has been fixed. Here is the invitation. Please do attend the marriage. Okay, thank you for the invitation. I will definitely attend the marriage. So here, invitation and accepting polite manner are there. Okay, right. Next. Activity 2. Work with your partner. That means in classroom. Invite your friend to do the following with you. Reverse roles and use different expressions. An example has been done for you. Okay. Here, you have to invite in the following situations your friend. 1. Come and jog with you in the mornings. You have to invite your friend, come and jog with you in the mornings. How do you invite? Why didn't you come and jog with me in the mornings? Like that. Next, go for yoga in the evening. How do you invite? Yes. Why didn't you command? Why don't you come for yoga in the evening? Right. You can say like that. Why don't you come and practice yoga with me in the evenings also? Next, play tennis with you. Why don't you come and play tennis with me? Here, you should not say go because you are inviting. You are inviting him to play with you. To play with you. So, you have to change that word. Okay. Why don't you come and play tennis with me? Next, go on a tour. Why don't you come and join me on a tour? Next, join computer classes. Why don't you join the computer classes? Attend a seminar on road safety. Why don't you attend a seminar on road safety? Like that. Modal expressions. Next, here is the detailed expression, detailed information about how to invite, how to accept, how to express inability. Okay. In accepting a formal invitation, it is important to respond appropriately. Appropriately means suitably. First, thank the person for the invitation and then express your acceptance. Okay, expressions used for accepting invitations. There are different ways of accepting invitation because this is English. You can use different expressions. Yes, thank you. Of course, I would like to. Thank you, that would be great. Thank you, that sounds great. On some occasions, you may not be able to attend and therefore you will have to politely express your inability to attend giving the reason. Expressions used for expressing inability to attend. See, thank you, but I am sorry, I may not. Suppose marriage function. Thank you for inviting me, but I am sorry, I may not attend the marriage. On the same day, I have an appointment with the doctor. So give some reason, whatever it may be. Thank you, but I am afraid I cannot give the reason. Thank you, but I won't be able to attend. Give the reason like that. You have to by heart all these expressions. In examination point of view, you get 1 mark questions, 3 marks questions and 5 marks questions from this lesson. It is very important. They ask you to write a conversation regarding extending invitation, accepting invitation, and also give some modal expressions. How do you invite? How do you accept? How do you express your inability? You have to give some modal expressions in 1 mark questions. Next, activity 3. Work in groups of 3. This means, okay, leave it. Make as many meaningful sentences as possible using the expressions given in the table. What you have to do is here. That means there are three points are there here. Invitation, first point is invitation, second point is accepting, third point is expressing inability. You have to write invite invitation sentence, expression, and you have to write accepting invitation sentence, and third one is expressing inability sentence. Okay, suppose one model. We can express invitations in two ways. One is, would you like to? And second one is, why don't you? Here. Would you like to come to party on Sunday? Sorry, Saturday. Would you like to come to a party on Saturday? Accepted. Yes. Thank you. Of course, I will come to the party on that day. Suppose inability. Thanks, but I'm sorry. I may not attend the party on Saturday because I will be out of station. Or why don't you come to party on Saturday? Yes, thank you. I would like to. You can change. You can. There are different ways of expressing thanks. Yes, thank you. Of course, I would like to. That would be great. That sounds great. That sounds great. That would be great. I would like to. Of course, I would like to. Yes, thank you. Inability. Thanks. I'm sorry. Thanks. I may not. Thank you. I'm afraid I cannot. Thank you, but I'm unable to. So, would you like to come to? Would you like to come out with me this evening? Yes, of course. Sorry, I can't. Why don't you come with me for a lunch? That would be great. I would like to, but I am unable to as I am busy. Would you like to come and see me? That sounds great. I am afraid I cannot. Why don't you listen to my new record? Of course, I will. I want to, but I am unable to listen. Would you like to come and meet my family? That would be great. I am afraid I cannot. Like that. Next, activity 4. Work with your partner. So, leave it. Write a complete dialogue and role play them. Each one of you can, take one situation to invite. Okay, right. Your friend invites you to attend his birthday marriage, brother's marriage. Your friend invites you to attend the his brother's marriage. So, write invitation, write acceptance, and also inability. I will give you one modal expression. You can write in any way. There are different ways are there. Okay. Suppose Deepak and Vinay. Deepak. Congrats, Raj. I would definitely attend your brother's marriage. Suppose, congrats, Raj. I'm afraid I cannot attend your brother's wedding as I have to travel out of the town on an emergency. Okay, next. Your neighbor invites you to join him at a cultural program in your locality on a festival day. How do you accept? How do you express your inability? Acceptance. That would be great. I will join you for culture program on festival day. Suppose if you want to say inability, that would be great, but I'm sorry, I'm unable to participate in the culture program as I have an exam on that day. In that, there are different reasons you can say. Okay, some common errors generally we make in invitations. Example, I invite you, Lakshmi, why don't you come to the party? Here, I invite you and Lakshmi, both are there. So, it is not good. So, delete it. I invite you and use Lakshmi. Okay, Lakshmi, why don't you come to the party, please? Next, invite him for the function. No, invite him to the function, not for the function. Okay, tips. Extend invitations with a smile. Practice using various polite expressions in your speech. Thank the person for invitation. Confirm your participation. If you are not able to confirm, it is polite to inform the reason for your inability to accept. Okay, next assignments you have to do. Extend an invitation to a local celebrity to be the guest of honor for the annual day function in your college. Okay. Next, suppose one modal expression. We, the students of final year civil engineering, have planned for the annual day function in our college on 15th of this month. We wholeheartedly invite you to the guest of honor to be the guest of honor and make this event colorful and lively in that way. Next, invite your seniors to attend a farewell party. We, the students of second year electrical engineering, are conducting a farewell party this Saturday for all the seniors. We would like you all to attend it and make it a memorable event. So you can write in a different manner. Okay, that is a different thing. So this is the lesson. Please go through it once again, repeat it once again. I will share the PDF along with this video in YouTube. Complete the assignments and activities. Write them in your notebook, fair notes. If you have any doubts, if you want any clarification, you can ask me in the live class, regular class. Until then, I am closing this session. Thank you very much.